Let us begin with tutorial number 13, design of IAR filter. Design a Butterworth Dittel IAR high pass filter using bilinear transformation by taking t equal to 0.5 second to satisfy the following specification. In the pass band, h of e to the power j omega should be greater than or equal to 0.707. less than or equal to 1 for a period 0.6555 to 5, and in the stop band h of e to the power j omega should be less than or equal to 0.2 for a period 0 to 0.455. draw the direct form 1 and 2 structure of the filter. Also find its frequency response.
Hello everyone. Let us begin with tutorial number 13. To solve the problems, we need to refer a table. Table is called as 3db Butterworth low pass prototype transfer functions. The value of n, ha of s. If the order n is 1, then the transfer function, normalized transfer function, is 1 divided by s plus 1 for a low pass filter. If the order is 2, then this is 1 divided by s square plus 1.414s plus 1. If the order is 3, then the transfer function is 1 divided by s cube plus 2s square plus 2s plus 1. It continues with higher orders, but let us try to solve using this table. Starting with the first problem, we need to design a Butterworth it's a digital IAR high pass filter, and we need to make use of bilinear transformation. The specification given is as follows: 0.707, the magnitude of h of e to the power j omega should be greater than or equal to 0.707, and it should be less than or equal to 1 for a period 0.65 pi omega should be less than pi, and h of that is in the pass band. In the stop band it should be less than or equal to 0.2 for a period omega greater than 0, less than 0.4 pi. We need to draw the direct form 1, direct form 2 structures for the design filter. Also we need to find the frequency response, and we have to take the value of t is equal to 0.5 second. Using this data, now let us try to design the Butterworth Dittel IAR high pass filter. Whenever we do that, you know that the parameters, specifications that are known to us are pass band, edge gain. It is AP. It is given as 0.707 and pass band edge frequency that is omega p is given as 0.65 pi. Stop band edge attenuation is given to us, or stop band edge gain is given to us, that is AS, it is 0.2, and stop band edge frequency is given by omega S is equal to 0.45 pi. All these parameters are given in the digital domain. We need to convert this into analog domain. Let me tell you these specifications that are given for a high pass filter, and here this is 0.45 stop band edge frequency, and corresponding to that you have 0.2. Then you have here the passband edge frequency 0.65 pi, corresponding to that gain is 0.707. This is high pass filter specifications. But in the case of design of digital IR filter, we have to design first the low pass filter. So the low pass filter will be something like this. Here now this becomes 0.45 pi for 0.707, that is going to be pass band. This is 0.65 pi, that is going to be 0.2. Now we have to design for low, first we have to design the low pass filter. So let us start with the low pass filter. The low pass filters, we need to find all the parameters in the analog domain. So omega p is given by 2 by t tan of omega p by 2, that is 2 by 0.5 tan of 0.45 pi by 2, because this is going to be our omega p. When you solve this, you get this as 3.4163 radians per second. Omega s is given by 2 by t tan of omega s by 2. This is your omega s. So this is 2 by 0.5 tan of 0.65 pi by 2. That gives you 6.5274 radians per second. Knowing the omega p and omega s, AP and AS values, we can find the order of the filter. It is given by n value should be greater than or equal to half of log 1 by AP square minus 1 divided by 1 by AS square minus 1 divided by log of omega P by omega S. Let us substitute the values. We get this as half of log of 1 divided by 0.707 whole square minus 1 divided by 1 divided by 0.2 whole square minus 1. divided by log of the value whatever we have got, omega p is 3.4163 divided by 6.5274. When you simplify this, you are going to get this as 2.454. So the order should be a whole integer, whole number. So let us take the value of n equal to 3, because n value should be greater than or equal to 2.454. So n value is equal to 3. This is the order of the filter. Now for n equal to 3, we need to refer the table. From the table, for order 3, we get the normalized transfer function for low pass filter. We get this as 1 divided by s cube 2s square plus 2s plus 1. So here, to convert the transfer function, we, in order to get unnormalized high pass filter transfer function, we need to put the value of s equal to, this is whatever we have got is for low pass filter. Now we have to get it for high pass filter. It is HA of s for low pass filter. We need to substitute the value of s equal to omega c by s. Omega c can be found by using the formula, either omega p divided by 1 divided by ap square minus 1 to the power 1 by 2n, or we can use the formula omega c is equal to omega s 1 by as square minus 1 to the power 1 over 2n. This is omega s. So when we put the value of omega s as 6.5274, and this is 1 divided by 0.2 square minus 1 to the power 1 by 6. So you get this as 3.8433. Any one formula can be used to find omega c. So we get HA of s for high pass filter. It is 1 divided by s cube plus 2s square plus 2s plus 1. We need to put the value of s is equal to 3.8433. divided by s. So we get this as 1 divided by 3.8433 by s whole cube plus 2 into 3.8433 by s whole square plus 2 into 3.8433 by s plus 1. So further simplification of this equation will give us s cube divided by s cube plus 7.6866 s square plus 29.5419 s plus 56.7632. This is the unnormalized transfer function of high pass filter. Now we'll convert this into digital domain. By substituting s equal to 2 by t, 1 minus z to the power minus 1, 1 plus z to the power minus 1. T is 0.5, so I get this as 4 into 1 minus z to the power minus 1, 1 plus z to the power minus 1. Substituting this in HA of S, we get this as 4 into 1 minus z to the power minus 1, 1 plus z to the power minus 1 whole cube divided by, it is 7.868666 into 4, 1 minus z to the power minus 1, 1 plus z to the power minus 1 whole square plus, it is, sorry, let me substitute this, we get this as s cube, in place of s cube I have 4, 1 minus z to the power minus 1, 1 plus z to the power minus 1 whole cube plus 7.6866 multiplied by 4 into 1 minus z to the power minus 1, 1 plus z to the power minus 1 whole square plus, it is 29.5419 multiplied by 4, 1 minus z to the power minus 1, 1 plus z to the power minus 1 plus 56.7632. Simplifying this, I am going to get the final answer as 8 minus 24 z to the power minus 1, 24 z to the power minus 2 minus 8 z to the power minus 3 divided by 45.2404 minus 3.316 z to the power minus 1 plus 15.144 z to the power minus 2 minus 0.3016 z to the power minus 3. So I can further simplify this. I get h of z is equal to 0.1768 z to the power 3 minus 0.5305 z square plus 0.5305 z minus 0.1768 divided by z cube minus 0.0732 z square plus 0.33482 z minus 0.0067. So we'll have to write it in direct form 1 and direct form 2. In the direct form 1, we have x values on the left hand side, y values on the right hand side. So we have z to the power minus 1, z to the power minus 1 and z to the power minus 1. So that I get here z to the power minus 2, z to the power minus 3. Needs to be added. The coefficients are here 0.1768 5305 with the negative sign, 5305. This is minus 0.1768, and here we have to write in terms of z to the power minus 1. So I get this as minus, this as plus, this as minus, this as plus. You have to take z to the power 3 out, then you will be getting the answer. So here also I have z to the power minus 1, z to the power minus 1, z to the power minus 1. We have to sum it up. So we have summas here. So it is here we have minus, that becomes plus here, 0.0067. Here we have 0.3348 with the negative sign. Here we have 0.0732. Output is going to be y of n. This we have got it because we have taken z cube out, denominator and numerator, so they get cancelled out. So we have in the numerator 1.1768 minus 0.5305 z to the power minus 1 plus 0.5305 z to the power minus 2 plus 0.1768, it's minus z to the power minus 3 divided by 1 minus 0.0732 z to the power minus 1, 0.33482 z to the power minus 2 minus 0.0067 z to the power minus 3. We have used this, therefore you can see that constant term is plus 0.1768. Then it is minus 0.5305 is associated with z to the power minus 2. Then plus 0.5305 associated with the z to the power minus 2, and minus 0.1768 associated with z to the power minus 3. Similarly, here all in the denominator coefficients becomes plus. So z to the power minus 3 is associated with 0.0067, and z to the power minus 2 with minus 0.3348. This is minus, and this is 0.0732 is associated with z to the power minus 1. This is direct form 1. Let us try to write it in direct form 2. The direct form 2, z to the power minus 1 block gets reduced. That means the number of memory location gets reduced while computing. So it is z to the power minus 1, z to the power minus 1, and z to the power minus 1. And here the left hand side you will be having the y values, and right hand side you will be having the x values. So we have y values on the right hand side. So we have this as 0.0067, and it is minus 0.3348. And here you have 0.0732. On the right hand side you have x values, the coefficients whatever we have here is -0.1768, and here it is 0.5305. Here it is -0.5305, 0.1768. Finally, he has asked you to compute the frequency response. The frequency response is given by H of omega. You have to substitute wherever you have Z. In place of Z, you have to substitute e to the power j omega. So you get this as 0.1768 -0.5305 e to the power -2j omega plus 0.5305 e to the power minus j omega -0.1768 divided by 1 minus 0.0732 e to the power minus j omega plus 0.3348 e to the power minus 2j omega minus 0.0067 e to the power minus 3j omega. This is the frequency response.
Design a second order digital bandpass filter, Butterworth filter, with the following specifications: upper cutoff frequency of 2.6 kHz, lower cutoff frequency of 2.4 kHz, sampling frequency of 8000 Hz. Also draw the structures in direct form 1 and direct form 2.
Let us try to solve the second problem of tutorial number 13. Here we have to design a second order Butterworth digital filter. With the given specifications, upper cutoff frequency FU is 2.6 kHz, lower cutoff frequency FL is 2.4 kHz, sampling frequency FS is 8000 Hz. We need to draw even the structure in the direct form 1 and direct form 2. So we'll compute WCU. It is 2 pi FU by FS. It is 2 into pi 2600 divided by 8000. You get this as 2.042 WL omega L. It is 2 into pi FL by FS, lower cutoff frequency, 2 pi 2400 divided by 8000. You get this as 1.8849. We'll convert this into analog domain. In the digital domain, is a band pass filter. Here he has given you omega L. Here he has given you omega U. This is omega U. Now we'll go to the analog domain using bilinear transformation technique. Omega U is equal to 2 by T tan of omega U by 2. So that will give you T is 1 divided by 8000. So let us substitute that. We are going to get two divided by 1 divided by 8000 tan of 2.042 by 2. When you simplify this, you get this as 2.6108. 10 to the power 8 radians per second. Keep your calculator in radians mode. Similarly, we need to compute omega L in the analog domain. 2 by T tan omega L by 2 is a bilinear transformation formula. 2 divided by 1 divided by 8000 tan of 1.8849 by 2. Keep your calculator in the radians mode. You get this as 2.2021 10 to the power 8 radians per second. Bandwidth, it is BW. Omega U minus omega L. When you substitute the values, 2.6108 minus 2.2021 10 to the power 8, you get this as 4086 radians per second. Omega naught square cutoff frequency, omega U into omega L, you get this as 2.6108 2.2022 10 to the power 8. Simplifying, we get this as 5.7495 into 10 to the power 8. Here we need to consider a normalized low pass filter transfer function from the table, but we have to be careful here. The order should be half of the order that has to be designed in case of band pass filter. So we need to consider the normalized low pass filter transfer function from the table, whose order should be half of the order that is defined for band pass filter. It is 2 here. So therefore, the low pass filter transfer function should have the order of 1. So I can get it from the table. It is 1 divided by S plus 1. Now we have to obtain unnormalized band pass filter transfer function by taking this normalized transfer function of low pass filter, substituting the value of S equal to omega P S square plus omega L omega U divided by S into omega U minus omega L. Omega P is 1 here. So we have S square plus 5.7495 into 10 to the power 8 divided by s 4086. So let us substitute. So you get for HA of S, band pass filter is 1 divided by S square 5.7495 into 10 to the power 8, 4086 into S plus 1. Simplifying this, we get this as 4086S, S square 4086S plus 5.7495. Now, we need to convert this into digital domain. We need to get H of Z from HA of S of band pass filter that we have designed by substituting the value of S equal to 2 by T, 1 minus Z minus 1, 1 plus Z minus 1. We had taken earlier T is equal to 1 by 8000. So therefore you get this as 16000, 1 minus Z minus 1, 1 plus Z minus 1. Earlier, if you have taken T value is equal to 1 during transformation from digital to analog, now we have to take the same T 1 from converting from analog to digital. So you need not take always T equal to 1 by 8000. You can take any value of T, but whatever value of T you have taken for digital to analog, same T should be taken from analog to digital transformation. So you get this as 4086 multiplied by 16000, 1 minus Z to the power minus 1, 1 plus Z to the power minus 1 divided by 16000, 1 minus Z to the power minus 1, 1 plus Z to the power minus 1 whole square, 4086 into 16000, 1 minus Z to the power minus 1, 1 plus Z to the power minus 1 with the constant term, here you had 10 to the power 8, 5.47495 10 to the power 8. Further simplification gives us 65376, 1 minus Z to the power minus 2 divided by 10 to the power 8, 7.6123 Z to the power minus 2, 0.713 Z to the power minus 1 plus 1. Further simplifying this, I get this as 0.0731 minus 0.0, this is a 5.7499. So you get this as 0.0731 Z to the power minus 2, 0.8575 Z to the power minus 2, 0.713 Z to the power minus 1 plus 1. This coefficient is going to be 16000 whole square, that has to be simplified. So you get this as 7.6123. So let us try to draw the direct form 1 structure. Here we have x of n whatever I'm drawing is for direct form 1. We have z to the power minus 1, z to the power minus 1. The left hand side will have x values, and x values you have to consider for x of values on the right hand side. We have here left hand side we have x values z minus 1, z minus 1. It has to be multiplied by minus 0.731, and this is also 0.70731. Goes to the right hand side, we have y values. And here we have minus 0.8575, minus 0.713. This is y of n, this is x of n. Direct form 2, we will reduce the delay block by half. So we have z minus 1, z minus 1. On the right hand side we have x values, that is here it is minus 0.0729. On the left hand side we have y values, this is minus 0.85475, this is 0.713 with the negative sign.